Again, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
There is, I should make a sign of the cross in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. There is a group, a religious group, in Iraq known as the Mandeans. Mandeans. They speak a language, a Semitic language, known as Mandaic. And really, their religious tenets are those of the Gnostics. The Gnostics would talk about a battle in the world between good and evil. The Mandeans spoke or worshiped God with regard to a battle between light and darkness. Now, why in the world, at the Church of the Visitation, am I speaking about the Mandeans? There's something very unique and interesting about this religious group. They reject Jesus and hold, because they feel that Jesus was the usurper and that John the Baptist was the one who was really important. After all, Flavius Josephus gave a great deal of attention to John the Baptist and mentioned Jesus in passing. So we see personified in this religion kind of a competition or a discussion about the relationship between Jesus and John. We're celebrating the Feast of the Visitation today, which is apparently an encounter between two women relatives, Elizabeth, who was older, and Mary, who was a young girl. That's the apparent celebration. What is also happening is there is, for the first time, an encounter between John the Baptist and Jesus. John the Baptist leapt in Elizabeth's womb when she encountered, when the two women came together. We don't know if Mary witnessed the birth of John the Baptist or not, only that after 3 months, she went home. But let's examine this relationship between John the Baptist and Jesus. If one looks at the narratives, the gospel narratives, it's very difficult to articulate a consistent narrative. As we just heard the deacon proclaim, Luke said they were relatives. Mark, in his gospel, preached that there was going to be a savior who was going to come to Israel. But he wasn't clear that it was going to be Jesus. Matthew depicts the disciples of John the Baptist approaching Jesus and saying, "Who are you? Are you the Savior? What is your status in all this?" John the Baptist was the one who was very, John the Evangelist was the one who was very careful to portray John as the precursor, one who was preparing the way for Jesus. John the Evangelist always portrayed John the Baptist as pointing elsewhere to Jesus. This tension between the relationship between John the Baptist and Jesus really takes place in our own lives as priests. As priests, we rightfully and beneficially can describe ourselves as alter Christus, another Christ. But that has its problems. Because if we go into a community and declare ourselves to be their savior, we have problems. First of all, we're wrong. There was only one savior. And if we go into the order of priests, because that's what you are ordained. You are ordained to an order. You are ordained to a group of priests who are serving the church. And if you walk into that order and say, I have all the answers, again, we have problems. John the Baptist, if we declared ourselves to be Alter Ioannes, maybe that can offer us a few insights. Our ministry would not be pointing to ourselves ever, but always directing people to Jesus. Not drawing attention to ourselves, but always pointing, that's Jesus. Sometimes people don't know where they can find him. That's Jesus. We can prepare ourselves. We can prepare the church to receive Jesus. And I think the greatest benefit to declare ourselves Alter Ioannes is that it really is our vocation in life to become less while Christ becomes greater. God bless you.